Good morning, praise the Lord. Today, June 7th, we'll talk about the next letter in worship, H. H stands for humble ourselves before Him. This is very important in every Christian's life. We have to humble ourselves. What do we have that we should be proud of? Everything that we have belongs to God, and we should be proud of our God who died for us. Nothing else. Luke 14:11, Jesus himself says, he who humbles himself will be exalted. These words are spoken by Jesus Christ himself, who was an epitome of humility. Paul writes about him that he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death on the cross. Therefore, God also has highly exalted him. You should definitely read the letter to Philippians 2:8-11 actually. Jesus is a good example for all Christians, and like him, we should humble ourselves, since humbling is a way of honoring God and worshipping him. In 2 Chronicles 6:13, we see King Solomon kneeling before all the assembly of Israel to pray to God at the time of dedication of the temple. This shows the humility of the king in front of King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Because of his lowly attitude, King Solomon was blessed abundantly with wisdom and health. We all know that he was the most wise person in the world and most wealthiest person in the world. Most of the churchgoers are not able to distinguish between praise and worship. Praise comes just from the lips, but worship comes from the heart when we know the greatness and understand the attributes of God. We'll see an example to understand this truth better. When Abraham Lincoln was the president of USA, he helped an old woman in getting down from a train. She was struggling to get down because of the height, and he helped her get down. She thanked him and praised him profusely for his kindness, and they left. The next day, when the old lady saw the news in the front page of a newspaper, she was thrilled and wanted to meet him. When she finally met, she fell onto her knees and worshipped him. Abraham Lincoln also should be commended for his humility. We should all fall at his feet and worship him. In 2 Chronicles 7:14, it's written, "If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sin and will heal their land." Not only them, but their land also. Since humbling ourselves is mandatory for prayer also, let's learn to humble ourselves. Humbling means we are worshipping God, who is the great God. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for teaching us that humility is also part of worship. Please help us to be humble, Lord. Amen.